بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. طلبة المرحلة الثانية. Our lecture today about the orbit and the eyeball. So started with the orbit. The bony component of the orbit. Orbit is pyramidal cavity where is the base in front and the apex behind. This is the orbit. Bone component. The base located. This is the opening considered as the base of the bony orbit and the apex located posteriorly. Now the component of the margin, bony component of the margin and the walls of the orbit. The margin superiorly the frontal bone, medially the maxillary process of the frontal and the frontal process of the maxilla, inferiorly the maxillary margin and the zygomatic margin, laterally the two process, the frontal process of the zygoma and zygomatic process of the frontal bone. This is the margin. Now the walls of the orbit, bony orbit, medially we have started with the frontal process of the maxilla, lacrimal bone, orbital plate of the labyrinth of the ethmoid, in addition to the this small part body of the sphenoid. Superiorly frontal bone and the lesser wing of the sphenoid. This is the optic canal between the body and the lesser wing. So the lesser wing consider as a superior part of the orbit. Laterally, we have the orbital plate of greater wing of the sphenoid and orbital plate of the zygoma. Inferiorly, the zygomatic bone, orbital plate of the maxilla, in addition to the small part of the palatine bone. Now the opening of the orbital cavity. The opening, the large one, is the orbital opening in which 1/6 of the orbit or of the eyeball exposed and the remainder located behind the superior and the inferior margin. The second opening is the optic canal. Optic canal for transmission, the optic nerve and the ophthalmic artery. Superior orbital fissure located between the lesser wing of the sphenoid and greater wing of the sphenoid for transmission, the oculomotor, trochlear, abducens and ophthalmic branch of the trigeminal nerve, in addition to the superior ophthalmic vein. The inferior orbital fissure for transmission, the terminal branch, which is the zygomatic nerve, in addition to the inferior ophthalmic vein and sympathetic branch. Infraorbital canal fissure groove and canal for transmission, the infraorbital nerve and the blood vessels, which is exit in the face through the infraorbital foramen. Medially, we have in lacrimal bone, we have nasolacrimal canal for transmission, the nasolacrimal duct, final drainage in the opening nasal cavity below the inferior conch. We have numerous other openings such as the interior and posterior ethmoid foramen for transmission, the interior and posterior ethmoid nerve and blood vessels. Also in the zygoma we have foramen for transmission, the zygomaticotemporal and the other foramen for transmission, the zygomaticofacial. In greater wing we have the foramen named meningeal foramen for transmission, the recurrent meningeal artery branch of the lacrimal. This is the zygomatic nerve branch from the maxillary nerve in pterygopalatine fossa, pass through the inferior orbital fissure, divided into the zygomaticotemporal, this is the zygomato, which give communication branch to the lacrimal nerve, which carry the parasympathetic secretomotor fiber to the lacrimal gland. And this is the zygomaticofacial in the face. Optic nerve enter the orbit through the from middle cranial fossa, pass through the optic canal as we said, accompanied by ophthalmic artery. The nerve is surrounded by the meninges, pia, arcanoid and dura mater. some textbook consider as extension of brain tissue. Now the other nerve, orbital nerve, is the nasocillary, the most important nerve, nasocillary. Nasocillary cross over the optic canal and give many branches. These branches as anterior, posterior, ethmoid nerve, infratrochlear, will supply the medial part of the upper lid and medial side of the lateral side of the nose. In addition, postganglionic short ciliary also give long ciliary, short ciliary, and communication branch to the ciliary ganglia. This is parasympathetic ganglia located in posterior part of the orbit between the optic nerve and lateral rectus nerve. The sensory fiber from the nasociliary, the parasympathetic from the lower ramus of the oculomotor, and the sympathetic, this is the sympathetic branch from the plexus around the internal carotid artery. So the branches of the nasociliary, communication branch, both ganglionic, short ciliary, anterior and posterior ethmoid, and infratrochlear. The other branch of the ophthalmic, frontal run over the superior palpebral muscle or palpebral superioris muscle, which is muscle of the upper lid. Finally, the frontal nerve divided into the supraorbital, supratrochlear. The other branch, which is the lacrimal. This is the lacrimal, which is run along superior border of lateral rectus to reach the sensory innervation to the lacrimal gland. It's joint branch from the zygomaticotemporal. Zygomaticotemporal carry parasympathetic fiber, which is considered as secretomotor fiber for the lacrimal gland. This is the lacrimal, which supply the lacrimal gland, and this is communication branch from the zygoma. This is the pterygobalatine ganglia. And this is the frontal, divided into supraorbital, supratrochlear, and nasociliary. This is the communication branch between the zygomaticotemporal and the lacrimal, frontal, and this is the nasociliary, ophthalmic, maxillary, and mandibular of the trigeminal, and this is the sympathetic plexus around the internal carotid artery, which is give sympathetic fiber to the ciliary ganglia. Ciliary ganglia finally supply the intraocular muscle, which is sphincter pupillae muscle and ciliary muscle of the inside the eyeball, frontal nerve. Trochlear nerve, a branch from the posterior surface of the midbrain, supply the superior oblique. Extraocular muscle, seven muscles. Four recti muscle, which is superior, medial, lateral, and inferior rectus muscle, in addition to the superior oblique, inferior oblique, and superior palpebral muscle, or superior palpebral superioris muscle. So all muscle of the extraocular of the orbit supply by the oculomotor, except the L6 lateral rectus supply by the abducens, and SO4 mean superior oblique supply by the trochlear. So L6, SO4, only the lateral rectus supply by abducens and superior oblique supply by the trochlear. This is the trochlear from the posterior surface of the midbrain to supply the trochlear artery, as nerve supply the superior oblique muscle. Oculomotor, a branch from the interior surface of the midbrain to divided into two rami, superior rami, and inferior rami. The superior rami supply the superior rectus and superior palpebral superioris, and the inferior rami supply the medial rectus, inferior rectus, and inferior oblique muscles. And this is the abducens from the groove between the bones and medulla oblongata to supply the lateral rectus. And this is the oculomotor divided into the superior rami and inferior rami. Also, it has communication branch to the ciliary ganglia, and this branch carries the parasympathetic fiber to these ganglia. Nasociliary, as we said, communication branch to the ciliary ganglia, long ciliary, and pass forward with the short ciliary nerve and pierce the sclera of the eyeball. They continue forward between the sclera and choroid to reach the iris. And long ciliary supply the dilated pupil, while the short ciliary supply the sphincter pupil muscle. Posterior ethmoid nerve supply the ethmoid and sphenoid air sinus. Infratrochlear supply the skin on the medial part of the upper lid and adjacent part of the nose. Interior ethmoid supply the meninges and interior cranial fossa and mucous membrane of the medial and lateral side of the nasal cavity, and finally emerge in the face as external nasal branch in lower border of the nasal bone to supply the skin of the nose downward as far as the tips of the nose. Abducens nerve, as we said, supply the, this is the abducens from the groove between the midbrain and medulla oblongata, will supply the lateral rectus. This is the green line. This is the trochlear from the posterior surface and oculomotor from the interior surface. Ciliary ganglia, as we said, parasympathetic ganglia in posterior part of the orbit between the optic nerve and lateral rectus muscle. Postganglionic short ciliary to supply the sphincter pupil muscle and ciliary muscle. And this is the ciliary ganglia, sympathetic from the sensory from nasociliary, and the sympathetic from plexus around the internal, and parasympathetic from lower ramus of the oculomotor. Both ganglionic as short ciliary muscle pierce the posterior wall of the eyeball. This is the ciliary. Now the blood vessels and lymph vessels of the orbit. Ophthalmic artery is a branch of the internal carotid artery that the vessels emerge from the cavernous sinus and enter the orbit through optic canal. So the ophthalmic artery divided many branches. The most important central artery of the retina, which end or enter the eyeball to reach the optic disc. Ciliary artery, short and long. Ciliary artery, lacrimal artery to the lacrimal gland, supraorbital, supratrochlear to the skin of the forehead. And this is the ophthalmic artery, posterior anterior ethmoid, dorsal nasal artery, supratrochlear artery, supraorbital artery, lacrimal artery, which give three branches, a branch to the lacrimal gland and a branch to the divided into zygomatico, tumoral zygomatico facial artery, and the branch to the communication, the middle meningeal, named the recurrent meningeal artery, passes through the foramen named meningeal foramen in a greater wing of the sphenoid in lateral surface of the orbit. And this is the dorsal nasal artery, and this is the lateral nasal artery branch from the facial, while the dorsal nasal artery branch from the ophthalmic artery. Ophthalmic vein, we have superior and inferior ophthalmic vein. The superior ophthalmic vein communication direct through the superior orbital fissure to the cavernous sinuses, while the inferior ophthalmic nerve go direct with the superior to the cavernous sinuses, and also communication through the inferior orbital fissure to the pterygoid venous plexus. Anteriorly, connection the facial vein through the supraorbital and supratrochlear. And finally, thank you very much.